How much wind energy is coming from those turbines outside?
The wind turbines can generate about 7.5 megawatts of power.
Each?
No, all 1.5 each.
1.5 each?
All five is 7.5. The plant itself is a wastewater treatment plant, and we utilize about 2.5 megawatts of power. So the additional five is available to go out to the grid. So when wind energy is, when wind is in a good condition, a little over 12 miles an hour, we're generating enough power here to run the whole wastewater treatment facility as well as sell out to the grid. On the average, it's making, it generates about 2 million kilowatt hours a month.
Okay.
And we purchase, as a wastewater plant, we purchase about 1.2 million kilowatt hours each month.
In order to run the?
In order to run the wastewater plant, and then the rest of it's sold to the grid. Because wind, as wind goes on, when it's windy, mm-hmm. they're generating far in excess of what we need.
Yeah.
We only need about 2.3 megawatts of power, and they could do 7.5.
Okay.
So when it's windy, they're exporting. When it's not windy, we're purchasing from the grid. The solar is all on our side. It's a 500 kilowatt facility, and it's only about 3% of our power needs. But we'll use that first. So solar we use first, second we'll use wind, and then if there's no wind and no solar, no sun, we'll buy from the grid.
The MMS has awarded what they call lease nominations to three New Jersey companies. Those three companies are looking forward this summer to putting in meteorological towers on the plots that they've identified to analyze the wind resource in the ocean. The plan would be for each of those companies to build 350 megawatts of offshore wind in 2012, 2013. So you really have a year of studying the resources, probably a year of permitting, a year of putting foundations in, then a year of construction for commissioning in 2012 and 2013.
A lot of people think we're over-aggressive. We don't think so. And we have an ongoing clean energy program where we are investing in projects like this, or like their solar panel array, or like the one on the rooftop of the convention center, where we have the second most number of installed solar panels in the country, second only to California. So it's actually amazing. These guys use this as a backup, as they just described. And we want to do the same thing with wind power.
Now, how is constructing an offshore wind turbine? Obviously, there's more depth to the water, but how's the construction process different than it would be for an onshore one, such as the ones here?
Well, here it's pretty easy. You know, you dig a hole, you build a pretty complicated foundation, and it's pretty much tinker toy construction after that when you put the pieces together. Offshore, it's in some cases putting a foundation in 65 feet of water, such as Fisherman Energy is proposing, is like building a casement for a bridge. It's a known technology. There's a way to do it. Fisherman's Energy, like I said, is going to be building monopole turbines in about 65 feet of water, about 10 miles out. Deepwater has certainly talked about a jacketed foundation, which is for a deeper water application. Their site, I think, is about 115 feet of water, and they're basically going to be building a bar stool type of foundation and then setting their turbines into that, which enables them to go into deeper water further offshore. I saw the other day, I think there are 38 offshore wind farms in Europe, the oldest of which was built in 1991. Most of them are relatively small. They're 6, 7, 8, they're the size of this wind park, actually, up to maybe 20 or 30 megawatts. But the ones that are going in now, and there are as many as 70 in planning in Europe, are large, several hundred megawatt farms. If you look between Cape Cod and Delaware, there are probably 3,200 megawatts of offshore wind in the pipeline in the United States, all of which is planned for the next 5 or 6 years.